documenting the birth of the Milano Model and Toy Museum. This is December 30th, 2001. So far, we've got our display window all set up, as you can see right here. Things are moving along. Let's go on inside.
116 Park Avenue in Elmhurst, Illinois. That's the address. Here we go. Going inside. This is where we are so far. This is going to be the gift shop right in the front here. As you can see, our counter. Some of our metal display cabinets are already up. Some of them are not yet up. This will be all gift store up to about that tape line right there. At that point, there will be a wall there. You'll enter the museum through a doorway over here. This is going to be where the street scene diorama is. You see, I've got all our shelving units lined up and ready to go. Wood, glass, metal rails. This will all is our magazine rack we just got. This will be all be playsets and toys and advertising memorabilia up here in the front section of the museum. You can see everything is still in boxes.
What you see here is the results of a lifelong dream come true, 25 years of dreaming and planning. This is the result.
And collecting.
And collecting and acquiring. And believe it or not, that's the truth. 25 years.
We got a scissors here.
Yes, we do. All right.
Now, wait a minute. Wait till we get our flashes ready and everything.
Dueling flashes.
You want to see this?
All right. I hope I can
get the same thing.
What a great night!
Congratulations, it's been a lifetime project and it's great, Dean. Did a great job. Really impressed. Thank you for involving me and letting me be a part of this.
Louis Marx was one of the first toy makers that incorporated using popular television shows and motion pictures. And this first one that you're looking at now is The Untouchables. It was produced by Desilu Productions in 1959 and lasted a couple of years. It's a pretty good rendition of, at least in toy scale, of that era. They actually had 16 separate figures, and you can, if you go around the back, you can see Al Capone making a deposit or a withdrawal.
Probably a withdrawal.
Probably a withdrawal. And Elliot Ness in his office over here. And I mean, nobody ever did anything like this with the. It's got like a little table and chair set up for dinner in a cafe and a bank teller office. And of course, the G-Man's office. And then if you pan down here, the next thing is, of course, Westerns were really huge.
Oh yeah.
And this is. It's not considered doll furniture by toy collectors. It's just called atmosphere pieces. So you got everything from a general store to a barber shop to the assay office for the gold miners,
mm-hmm.
and a little upstairs room. I wonder what that was for.
It's a kid show, right? Can't talk about that.
And underneath is a bar. And if you look real close between the swinging doors, there's a fight going on.
Right, there they are. Somebody's on
Mike
the butt.
Mike Riley knocks down one of his opponents. Well, that's the replica of the Disneyland that was produced. Disneyland opened in 1955, and of course, Louis March had been working with Disney since the beginning, making tin toys, and he just transferred all that technology and know-how to making plastic figures. This is the Disneyland playset. Tomorrowland, the world of things to come, the Main Street USA, Adventureland, Western theme, Frontierland, and of course Fantasyland, the happiest kingdom of them all.
The circus. Everybody loves the circus.
Everybody loves that, but that happens to be from a TV show called Super Circus, and you had Mary Hartline was the star of the drum major. And
what year was that in?
That was like early 1950.
Really?
Yeah.
And then
Scampi the Clown.
Is that a, you got some over here?
Oh yeah, here they are, right here.
I went in there with the Girl Scouts. Where are they?
There's Mary Hartline, Scampi, Nicky, and Scuffy, the tramp clown. And then Kurt Kaiser was his name, is the ringmaster, the white guy there.
Mm-hmm.
He became the voice man. He was the pitch man for all the Mark's toy commercials.
Hmm.
After that, he made a tremendous living after
Remember
that.
Remember they'd have those money, you put your hand in, as much as you could grab? You could
Bozo Circus took a lot from that. But here you have the older version of the airport and a newer version. And you can see it's just jam-packed, kind of. This is sort of what it would look like if they did expand O'Hare Airport.
Mm-hmm.
It would just be jam-packed, lots of pollution, and too many people. Mm-hmm. Cramming all those runways into one space. It's a little political.
This was a TV series, huh?
TV series was the Alaskans.
Now, I have a question about this. Why would the igloos be right in front of the general stores, stores?
The mats that they made were designed to give that illusion, he had Louis Marx had that sense of theatrics
mm-hmm.
in him. Of course, we're cramped for space here, but the thing was really made for like a big train table layout.
Got it.
All right, so that you would have the town a little further away from the wilderness. That's supposed to represent all these icebergs here and mounds are supposed to represent the Alaskan wilderness. And of course, the Eskimos would be on the outskirts of that, dealing with the fur trappers, see?
Mm-hmm.
And then they would deal with then the fur trappers would go into town with their furs and trade in the Alaskan Trading Company, see?
Okay.
Then below you here, you've got Doc Tari. And here he is, Doc Tari is sitting in his Jeep, and they don't have Clarence across that line, but they have everybody else here.
Well, explain to me what Doc Tari is.
Doc Tari was meant doctor in Swahili.
Mm-hmm. And this is a program?
The show was based on this TV series about this doctor who took care of animals that had been injured or hunted and were rescued. And here he has a number of different native tribes.
Right.
What they did too with this was they combined an old set, which was called Jungle Jim, which starred Johnny Weissmuller. When that show went off the air, they just combined the sets together. And the interesting thing about Louis Marx is that the white figures always represented some character figure.
Okay,
some
I noticed
character
that.
On television. Like down below here, you've got the Flintstones.
Oh, okay. Let's take a look.
That's bedrock.
Yes, it is.
And here's the little sign, bedrock. And of course, Fred is sitting right out in front with his Flintstone mobile with Dino.
Dean Milano's in there?
Yeah, Dino Milano is Dino. This is from an old TV show. The first issue of this was from an old TV show called Space Patrol. And then they called it Rex Mars. And I think the other one, it wasn't Captain Video, but it was Rocky Jones. And there are the character figures in the front there.
Okay.
But once again, they took all the same kinds of characters. You have the aliens coming down the corridor here, meeting the spacemen on the outside.
Uh-huh.
they were all the same figures, but they just gave it a different name, mm-hmm. and it gave it a whole new life.
Did they ever come out with toys like this for Prince Planet? Remember Prince Planet?
No.
It was a cartoon. No.
Right next to it is Cape Canaveral.
Kid Canaveral.
But once again, what they did was they reissued figures from an old military set that mm-hmm. they had, and just because you have figures carrying right. you know bandoleros of bullets mm-hmm. and they're really not astronauts at all. Those came later. But you know, he had that ingenious way of recycling stuff.
Yeah, that's the interior side of the open side of the skyscraper set. It didn't sell very well. That's why it's one of the rarest and most expensive of all.
Dean's probably the only guy who has it.
He's one of the few that has a complete set. Mm-hmm. Because this stuff is it wasn't really something you played with. I mean, you got what do you got? You got a guy here who's a warehouse man. You got a couple of people playing ping pong, a coach, an office, and you know some stores on the bottom, and a doorman and such. And it didn't have that kind of play value that they thought.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, you can't have a lot of fun with the maintenance man.
Unless you have people jumping off together. Or
right.
Something.
Mr. Marks.
He was so vain that he had a figure made of
himself. That's great. That's my type of guy. There he is. Looks a little bit like Alfred Hitchcock / Mayor, the original Mayor Daley.
Sears was a great distributor of Marks toys, and they actually commissioned them to make their own Sears store. Mm-hmm. And you can see it's very unique compared to all of the other
What year would that store be from? The 60s or the 50s?
That's about 1959.
Okay. I need to get a tie for tonight.
Very busy. Let's see.
Miss, can you hold on to your child, please? Hey, there's a lawnmower right by where I would buy a watch.
Pick up in line 3. Pick up in aisle 3.
Looks like the policeman acted on the other policeman.
That's right. It was actually a movie, and then they turned it into a three-parter for the Disneyland
the Red
television
Coats.
Show. Yeah, the Red Coats for Sons of Liberty
versus the
American
Red
Revolution. Got all the different characters from some of his major movies at that time, which was about 1955 when this came out.
Mm-hmm.
He had Pinocchio, Dumbo, Snow White, Alice in Wonderland, Peter Pan, and then all the other little Disney characters, Mickey, Minnie, Donald Duck, and his nephews, and Daisy, and Pluto, of course.
Fantastic.
A company called Susie Goose that was a competitor. All of these figures were sculpted by the same company. They were the Areola brothers out of Pennsylvania, and they were such great sculptors that even Mark's competitors hired them to do all of the work, all the intricate little details in the positions,
uh-huh.
the poses, and even the furniture. You could see beds and benches.
Right.
It's just wonderful stuff.
This is a typical split level Mark's dollhouse from probably late 50s. The neat thing about some of these dollhouses is the great 50s style decor inside. All the decorating just screams 1950s. They really nail it on some of these. The furniture and the tin lithography on the walls, the knotty pine paneling in the living room. Just beautiful stuff. These are a couple of Mark's play sets from the 1950s. The first one here is the Pet Shop play set, which was based on a common building they used for three different sets, the schoolhouse, the nursery, and the pet shop. The second one here is the Mark's Firehouse play set, which is actually one of the rarest play sets there is. I've only seen one. That's the one I've got here. You don't see these very often. This is probably the rarest playset or toy in the entire museum here, and I believe it's probably one of the rarest playsets in the world, to tell you the truth. And I think a lot of collectors will concur with me on that. This is the Susie Goose Friendly Folks Supermarket playset. This is the only one that I've ever seen. I've heard about a second one
that went at auction for many thousands of dollars. Beautiful set of all the miniature products, the boxes and the cans. Also, the colors you see were painted by me. It actually comes with all white plastic parts, but they just screamed for turquoise and everything else. So I actually painted the cases and the counters, and I painted the figures. I put the chrome on and everything, as it would have looked back in the 50s to give it a more realistic look. This is the deluxe reading dashboard toy that was available back in probably the late 1950s. And you could only buy this through grocery stores. You could not get this in toy stores, only available through grocery stores. Beautiful detail. The windshield wipers work, you know, put batteries in it. It makes little motor sounds, the turn signal lights work. Very detailed, very expensive antique. This is a little bit of a cheaper version that Remco did, the Firebird 99 dashboard. It doesn't have quite the appeal of the other one. This is another deluxe reading, grocery store only set. I forget what it was called. It's the TV Jet Johnny something. But when the screen lights up, it shows an airplane on there, and it flies over the terrain as you steer it, and it shoots missiles and everything else. Very neat set. This is a series of My Mary play sets that were available in the late 1950s through the early 1960s. The incredible thing about these sets is that all these little boxes you see actually contain real product. I mean, there is, you know, there's grass seed in that box, there's does and ivory snow soap in there, toilet paper, little miniature model kits, all real product, which is something you could never get away with today, of course, because people would be so afraid that their kids would be eating the soap out of the boxes and stuff, of course, which we never did, but nowadays they suspect that the kids would do that, so can't do it. Plus of all the licensing arrangements, you could never get these licensing arrangements anymore today, all these product names and stuff, it would cost you so much. The license that each place that would cost you $100 by the time you paid the royalties on it. But luckily we were able to have these back in the 50s, and they're beautiful sets.
Dean Street is a big long diorama. It's about 15, 16 feet long, and it is used to showcase a lot of the model cars that we have in the museum on the street, and it also is a little residential street and a little business district from like the late 1950s in America. The houses are particularly important because they have some historic significance. There's a company called Tootsie Toy, which a lot of car collectors will recognize that name. And back in the 1920s and 30s, Tootsie Toy not only made little cars, but they made metal dollhouse furniture. And these houses were built by Tootsie Toy to display this metal dollhouse furniture at the various trade shows and hobby shows, toy shows back in the 1920s and 30s. So these houses are about 80 years old. And I'm in the process of restoring several of them. There's five of them in the Dean Street series right now. And they're beautiful pieces. They come apart. They have rooms in them and basements and stairs and everything. And they're pretty neat.